I only came obliged, but here I am. And if every time, if I'm to be at the end of this expo, what we're talking about, let me be the end. But if every time I want to sit down, have a rest, I have to brush away half a dozen of rabbits' smaller friend relations, then this isn't an expo, whatever it is at all. It's simply a confused noise.
I see what ear means if you ask me.
I'm not asking anybody. I'm telling everybody. We can look for the North Pole, or we can play Here We Go Gathering Nuts in May. This in part of Ant's Nest. It's all the same to me.
Come on!
Come on!
We're starting!
All right, we're going.
This is the first verse.
First verse of what?
My poem.
What poem?
This one.
Which one?
If you listen to it, you'll hear it.
How do you know I'm not listening?
They all went off to discover the pole. Owl, Piglet, and Rabbit and all. Eeyore, Christopher, Robin, and Pooh, and Rabbit's relations all went too. Though where the pole was, none of them knew. Hey ho for Owl, Piglet, and Rabbit and all.
Hush! You're coming to a dangerous place.
They came to a stream which twisted and tumbled over high rocky banks.
You see, dangerous, just the place for an ambush.
Is it a gorse bush sometimes?
My dear Pooh, you know what an ambush is?
Owl, Pooh's whisper was perfectly quiet, and there was no...
An ambush is a sort of surprise.
An ambush, as I was telling Pooh, is a sort of surprise.
So is a gorse bush sometimes.
If people jump out at you suddenly, that's an ambush.
It's an ambush, Pooh, when people jump out at you suddenly.
A gorse bush sprang out at me one day when I fell out of a tree. It took 6 days to get all the prickles out.
We're not talking gorse bushes, Pooh.
I am.
We better eat our provisions, so we won't have much to carry.
What?
What we've brought.
That's a good idea.
Have you all got something?
Yes. All except me, as usual. Is anybody sitting on a thistle by chance?
Yes, I believe I am. Yes, I thought so.
Thank you, Pooh. If you quite finished with that, it doesn't do them any good, you know, sitting on them. It takes the life out of them. Remember at another time, all of you, that a little consideration, a little thought for others makes all the difference.
Yes, of course. I didn't want the others to hear.
Quite so.
It's just that Rabbit, it's only, do you know what the North Pole
looks like? Well, now you're asking me.
Well, I did know at one point, but I've only sort of forgotten.
It's funny, I've sort of forgotten too, although I did know once.
I suppose it's just a pole stuck in the ground?
Well, yes, by calling it a pole, it must be a pole. And if it's a pole, then it must be sticking somewhere, because there'd be nowhere else to stick it.
Okay. Well, yes, that's what I thought.
The only thing is, where is it sticking?
That's what we're trying to find.
So they went back to the others. Michael was sweeping painfully, and Rue was watching the stream. The first time I came to help.
And as I watched, I swim.
I don't hold with all this modern, behind-the-ears nonsense. What do you think, Pooh?
Well, I think...
Well, we'll never know what Pooh thought, because...
because through the storms we can move the flag. The wild flag will come.
Piglet walked home in the golden evening.
When you wake up in the morning, Pooh, what's the first thing you say to yourself?
What's for breakfast? What do you say, Pooh?
I say, I wonder what's going to happen exciting today.
It's the same thing. So this is where we say goodbye to the 6-pine tree and the 100-acre wood, and Pooh and Piglet and all the others. And what did happen the next day? If we think of it, we'll be sure to tell you. Mm-hmm. Good night!
Thank you.
Thank you.